round heavyweight battle.
All right, fight fans, here we go. The first fight of the evening, scheduled for 10 rounds, and these are the big boys of boxing, your heavyweight division. Introducing the man in charge of the action. When the bell rings, your referee, Jorge Alonso. All right, fight fans, here we go. 10 rounds of heavyweight action. Introducing first, fighting out of the corner to my right. He hails from Charlotte, North Carolina, and tipped the scales at 239 fighting pounds. He has a professional record of 21 big wins, 17 defeats, 1 draw, and 13 big victories coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight he fights from the blue corner, wearing white trunks, introducing Otis Tisdale. His opponent stands opposite in the corner to my left, hailing from Havana, Cuba, and weighing in at 224 fighting pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, he takes an impressive record into the ring tonight at 26 big wins, 5 defeats, 2 draws, and 14 of those wins coming by way of knockout. Introducing your red corner, wearing the red trunks trimmed in white, here he is, Eliezer Castillo. Once again, here is your referee, Jorge Alonso, with last-minute instructions. 10 rounds in your heavyweight division.
And the referee telling the fighters everything that's gone on in the dressing room. And they'll tap up and get ready to go. And let's take a look at the matchup. Castillo is 34, Tisdale 36. The height, is it favored Castillo as well as the reach? Here we go, round one. Eliezer Castillo in the red trunks and Otis Tisdale in the white. Castillo, of course, the southpaw. Dave Fontempo along with Michael Moore. Michael, how do you feel every time you see a left-handed heavyweight? Little mirror image for you, huh?
I'm the first one to become heavyweight champion.
Yes, indeed.
That's important to me. We have two guys in here. Eliezer Castillo, seeing him in the gym, this is the most focused I've seen him. Looks to be in great shape. You notice Tisdale, the last time he fought here, he didn't look like he was in great shape before, but it looks like he's in better shape this time.
But Tisdale telling us that he's already started psychologically on the next leg of his career. He's framing up houses. It's worked very well for him. And that's a good idea when you've been losing fights and not really making a big run to get your life in order. But for Castillo, there's still time to do some things in boxing. And it probably came out of the training sessions you talked about. He was coming off a couple of losses. And Kendrick Rutherford, the last one. And it seemed like a fire's been lit under him.
Yeah, I would say so, because this is the most actually good.
And there's that fire we're talking about. Tisdale already on the canvas. Let's see, does Castillo want to go for it here? He comes in, body work by Castillo. He might make Tisdale quit. Good right hook by Castillo. Tisdale ready to fall. Uppercut by Castillo. Second knockdown of the round. And Tisdale doesn't like how he's being framed up right here.
As you said, hard knocks at the hard rock.
He is being drilled here. And now Tisdale trying to hang on to the legs. Tisdale should be trying to hold on. And he can, and Castillo just getting a chance to tee off. Tisdale trying to open up a little bit here.
I think there's a three knockdown rule in effect.
Yeah, the three knockdown rule in effect, so once more. And it's automatic for Castillo. Big uppercut by Castillo. And Tisdale somehow is still erect, but for no longer. That's the third knockdown, and that's the show. We with 16 seconds left in the round. Eliezer Castillo officially takes care of business. And you know what? Why let the guy get into the fight? That's smart. He knew this, the opponent was hurt. He went right in.
Exactly. I felt he had to do it because he knew he had to knock down. He get one more knockdown, I think he did.
Excellent job.
So Eliezer Castillo parlaying some good gym work into a nice performance. So Castillo unfurls the three strikes rule here on Otis Tisdale. It did not take Eliezer Castillo long to get into the knockdown mode. He's all happy there after his victory. He got the three knockdowns, and it did not take long. As you take a look at Tisdale getting attention, here's the first knockdown as Castillo steps in. He got good leverage, Michael.
He got a good uppercut. He had a good uppercut. He slapped with the left hand, but it hit him right on the chin. As he came, he knew he was hurting that right uppercut, and as came back with the straight left, being a southpaw, me being a southpaw, I see what he did. The third knockdown here, he's coming back headhunting, but he was hit more effective with the head shots.
And he continues to step up the pressure. You know, he knew that Tisdale did not have that real fighter look in him tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this one comes to a close at the 2-minute, 43-second mark of round number one. Your winner by way of knockout, Eliezer Castillo.
So Eliezer Castillo breaks the losing jinx, and he does it in dominant fashion. The way he's going to win a fight, convincingly in round one.
That's exactly right. He came out, he knew he was stronger than the guy. He knew he was stronger than Tisdale. Once he came out and established his power, it was all up to him.
So Castillo gets the victory. He improves his record, and he gets a very nice confidence-boosting effort. Eliezer Castillo able to put it all together, get three knockdowns. He shows you the muscles, and he had muscle in the first round of this fight. This is the coup de grace. As he puts the finishing touches on this victory, he becomes 27-5-2 with 15 knockouts. And for Otis Tisdale, it is an early night of heartbreak.
I bet that hard work pays off, because you train so hard at gym, then have a good victory like this, and look great. Excellent job with the steal.